Dying while we live, the cry of our dying soul. Death is not the greatest loss in life. The greatest loss in life is what dies inside us while we live. Everyone has a purpose and destination in life. And yes, we are endeavoring to live a life we dream and desire. We live each day trying to make a living and making it better or worser depending on the efforts and reactions we give to our challenges we face each day. We surround ourselves with different tastes of people, people with different dreams, different lifestyles, different ways of living, one who is always filled with positivity while another living a life of hatred with negative thoughts winding their life that even they themselves don't like the way they look at things for an instant. We are living in a diversified world where people have unique perception and ideology that even a blind man would be able to see in someone's eye because we have our own way of looking at things, a significant vision towards something that is different from others. What hinders us today in the society and the world in a larger respect is that most of us succumb to despair, to our own thoughts and don't live our life while we are actually living. Many among us are dying while we are actually living and breathing. Our soul is crying deep inside of us because we often forsake it by not living while we live. Often do we forget that the limit of life and its beauty is boundless. Don't limit yourself within your thoughts. You are what you think. If you think and believe that you are capable in doing something, then you can do it. Our subconscious mind can do in a way that is unimaginable to us. Whatever we plan in our subconscious mind and nourish with repetition and emotion will one day become reality because once the subconscious mind accepts an idea, it begins to execute it. It is a program for our mind to channel our thoughts in the right direction and execute its function command by our conscious mind. So most of us spend our day being gloomy and sad, being unable to be happy and not able to bring out the smile in us because we don't channel our thoughts in the positive direction. Thinking of what someone had said to us, quarreling with our friends, family members, or because we don't have what we desire. All these negative but useless thoughts, which will bring no positive impact but only a hindrance in our life, filled our mind that we remain sad and uncontented in our life. No matter what we're going through, we are capable to break out from the negative side. We keep pondering on the other side of our life, the ugly lifestyle we lived, the possessions we cannot afford to have, the luxuries we cannot enjoy, the sparkling clothes in the storeroom we dream to wear one day, the seven-story building with all kinds of decent lifestyles we would like to enjoy and whatnot are what makes us feel uncontent. When we are actually showered with countless blessings with the life we are given today, when millions are lying breathless in the graveyard, when thousands are lying on their deathbed only waiting to breathe their last, dreaming how they would wish to be alive today, this day. Imagine yourself as one among those. How precious the life we have today would be. The small things which you have negligence as waking up every morning safe and sound, the sun that shines every day, the family you're together with, the friends you surround yourself with would then be the greatest gift and possession in our life. The things you dream to have today would then mean nothing to you, for nothing is worth if we are not healthy and happy with it. What good and benefit is to a man to own 1,000 acres of land with branded cars and coveted property if we are not able to enjoy them because we don't have a good health and have no satisfaction upon them? Life is too short, and we only live once. So why not live life to the fullest and actually live the life we want? Steve Jobs once said, "Your time is limited. Don't waste it living someone else's life. Don't be trapped by dogma, which is living the result of other people's thinking. Don't let the noise of others' opinion drown your own inner voice. And most important, have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. They somehow already know what you truly want to become. Everything else is secondary." How do you feel about our life today? Are we living our best life? Are what we should be asking ourselves today? If our answer to the above is a no, maybe, or not sure, that means we're not living our life to the fullest, which really shouldn't be the case because you're the author of your life. Create and live the life you design and destine. Pen your own story. Why settle for anything less than what we can get? We deserve nothing but the best. So live every day on a fresh new start. Don't be held back by what happened yesterday or the past. Life is too short to ponder upon the past, which we have no control over them, and to bring them back. Live in the now. Live in the present moment and do the things you love. If you don't enjoy something, then don't do it. Spend your time and energy on things that bring you happiness and fulfillment. And most importantly, learn to be positive and always train yourself to think positive. Take perceptions that empower you, not those that bind you. If you can learn to see the positive side of everything, you'll be able to live a much richer life than others. Above all, live yourself. You are the one who is solely constant in your life. Remember to always treasure and love yourself, or no one's going to love you like you do to yourself. Of all these, never forget this. Love life. Living and thriving on this planet is a fascinating experience for all of us. How we're on Earth with millions of species, over 30,000 different life forms, and over 7 billion people, and every one of us are struggling and thriving in our own way. So as we live on Earth, remember to love life. It's the only way we have to live. As Norman Cousins rightly quoted, "Death is not the greatest loss in life. The greatest loss in life is what dies inside us while we live." So let's bring out the potentiality we have within ourselves. Let us live the life we desire while we are living.